Hey everybody, Coach Doug here. I'm sharing with you today all my bread and butter, butterfly guard stuff. Certainly there are other moves, but mastery of these positions and mastery of these postures and these moves will really allow you to add anything else into your game. I mean, just the other day, Christian, one of my brown belts, was showing me this really slick entry into the honey hole from the rock up position or the sweep. By getting all this stuff down and having it, you can snap stuff on like Legos. But this is really strong. It deals with if people are standing up, if people are kneeling, if people are pressuring, if people are, so it gives you a full game. And like I said, you can check with any of my students. These 21 moves are stuff I do on a daily basis. Butterfly guard can be so devastating and so strong if you learn how to control using your hooks and your underhooks and your grips. So take some time, pay attention to the details. Drill. You got to practice this stuff 100 times, 1,000 times, and get it down. Work it against lower belts and then try to work it against higher belts. Like I said, bread and butter stuff, a really complete system. It's what I teach all of my students, and they do really well with this. So best of luck. Let me know if you have any questions. Thanks.
Forehead.
Head position, right? Not just hanging out here where you can mash my head. Check. So this kind of, some people will call this like a sitting up guard. I really don't. For me, a sitting up guard, when we're talking about sitting up guard, it's this leg in here. Okay? I can be here. I can be here. Sometimes I'll be like, oh, I'm going to my sitting up guard. You know, but for me, sitting up guard is here. So the same posture, just that I'm controlling the leg. Does that make sense? So from the water back to the butterfly, there's a couple different postures here, right? Where does he want to be? Flattening me out, right? So controlling the hips, pushing my heels to my butt, and keeping my feet close together, controlling, working his pads, right? So here's one posture, it's flat. Is this the end of the world for me? Heck no, there's plenty of stuff you can do. This generally gives him more control, right? We can also be part of the way up. I can be fighting here. I've got pressure in my legs. I'm pulling. I've got a push-pull here. Depending on which way he goes, you know, gives me things that I can do just off of his motion, right? He goes forward. He comes forward. Then he's giving me momentum to take advantage of. If he's going backwards, it helps me sit up, all right? So there's the flat. There's the halfway up, and there's the up, right? And I can be here, I can have one underhook, I can have both underhooks, I can have an overhook, right? This whole, all of these things play. The main thing is when I'm here, I need to have grips, okay? All the grips that I use in judo and everything else work here, right? Collar tie, power grip, lapel, wrist, elbow, two on one side, underhook, overhook, double, and I also have the pant grab here, right? No gi, what do I do if I can't grab? What do I do?
Block.
It's just a knee tap, right? I do stuff over that. So we've got all these control points. Also, don't forget your feet. Feet in the hips, feet in the knee. Put the pressure here all the time. I don't want to just be sitting here with my feet trying to do everything with my hands because then he's got those controls and he's going to pass. I want to be putting pressure on his feet. I'm messing up his balance with my feet there, right? And he's got to deal with that, right? It doesn't really matter what grips I have, right? I can switch grips, control. See? He pushes me back, come back up. can do to beat them. So I have to be aware of the game here as well, once I'm moving. There's things that are going to change when I'm halfway through the sweep. Does that make sense? Okay. Any questions on the postures or the grips? No? All right, let's review our sitting up from the basic, right? Whichever side he's looking to, you're fine. Whichever side he's looking, whichever hand he's looking at is the one I'm gonna use. I take like a karate chop mode here, right? I use my hips, pop, and this comes under, and I get a good cross piece of my elbow, okay? Now, I put pressure here, I kick my legs up and out, right? But I'm using this to help me out. I usually get another grip here as well, right? So, up with the elbow, control here, kick my feet up and out to sit up. Right away, this leads to our basic game where I get my underhook and hips, get in here, and start working the basic sweep. Check. Once again, he's trapping, he's controlling. Even if he's really trying to stay on here tight, and he knows what I'm trying to do, stop it. It's really hard to stop. Okay? I just kind of wait for that space to open up. I pop my hips up, and then it's in there. Right? I pop and drop them real quick. And then I'm there. Okay? Elbow up, control, push away, put the underhook, start working my games, basic sweep. Oh, one more thing. You'll see people teach the butterfly where the head has to be here, where the head has to be here, where the head has to be certain places. Look, the only place the head has to be is not here, okay? Not where he can mash me. If I'm gonna go here, I keep my forehead up, let him mash me, right? Now it's how I keep my forehead on. So I can be on this side, I can be on this side. Preferably I'm not hanging out here ear to ear, but really, it's not that big a deal once I start the sweep. And it's not good for wrestling, but on the sweep it's not a good thing. Or it's not good for wrestling, but on the sweep it really doesn't matter. Alright, so don't get too hung up on it. In fact, practice it with your head in a different position. Alright? So let's just do the review from the basic class and use that cross face, that karate chop cross face. Go to the underhook. Remember, go to the underhook. You can grab the belt if I want, right? Good. Hands, hips, underhook, head position, I control the elbow. I fall back, right? Where do I fall? Yeah, to my side. And then I lift that up. And I hit the sweep. If I need a little extra juice, all right, if I need a little extra juice, I'm up. Check. Let's do it.
On the butterfly guard, my hooks are in, my hands are here. I don't want him controlling my ankles and my knees and all that kind of stuff. If I'm out here, it's a different game. We're gonna start off with a closer in game, okay? There's 4 points. When I'm looking for my underhook, I'm just looking for my basic butterfly sweep here, okay? It's like an elevator sweep. But it's with the elephant, with the butterfly. My butterfly hooks are in, I don't have that leg to the outside. There's 4 main points I'm looking for, okay? I'm gonna put my hand down, I'm gonna move my hips out, okay? So hand, hips, I get my underhook, and my hook is out here by the knee. I don't want my hook up here in his groin, I want it down here by the knee so that I get some leverage, okay? So hand, hips out to the side, scooting into them. Under hook is my third H, and my head position is my fourth H. Okay? Now, from here, I'm gonna control this far arm. Okay? I just control this far arm. Now I lay to my side. Okay? Lay to my side. And lift me up on this side. From here, he goes over. As soon as his balance breaks, I cut my knee across.
So then I'm going into kind of like a cross knee position. You can go to the mount here, and that's fine, but a lot of times you'll get your foot caught in there
and he'll put you in the half guard. Okay? With the cross knee, I block his hips and it's harder for him to do. Pull up on the arm, sit through to my good jiu-jitsu style scarf hold here. Okay? So once again, okay. My hand goes out here so that if he's trying to put pressure on me, if he's trying to flatten me down, I don't want to be flat. See, this hand helps me out here. So I can put my hand out, I put my hips to the side. See, now that's redirecting where he's going. I want to get my underhook. If I can grab the belt, I can grab the belt, but I don't need it if it's no-gi. If his head's below mine, that's fine. If his head is up more, then I want my head in his neck. Okay, I don't want to be forehead to forehead with him. I want to have this inside angle. Now I grab this far arm, sucking it in under my underhook here, making it, you know, using my overhook. Now I lay to my side, okay? Lift it up with this leg. As his balance breaks, my knee puts across. And I can come to side control or start control. Start, depending on where we're at. So what's my first stage?
Hand.
Hips.
Underhook.
Head position. Okay? Snatch up this arm. Where do I lay to? Yeah, to my side. If I lay straight back, I'm just flattening myself out. I don't attack his base at all. That's what I don't want to do. So I lay to my side. Boom. And that makes this go up. Okay, if I'm in here by his groin, it's harder to do. I don't have the same leverage. His leg's a lever, I'll far out the lever. Again, if I do this, and I just go to the mount, okay, grab the leg. Yeah, guys will grab the leg and push you in the half guard. Okay, if I, as I'm sweeping him, okay, try to put me in the half guard. If as I'm sweeping him, I cut my knee across, now he doesn't get that. So I like that. I know a lot of people like to sweep to the mount for 6 points. But if I end up in the half guard, I'd much rather be in the side control or star and not have those points. Because from here I can do a lot more damage. If he puts me in the half guard, now it's a bad one. He's got a chance to sweep, he's got a chance to attack, he's got a chance to get advantage. On the side, he doesn't have that. Here we go. Any questions on the basic sweep? No? Alright. So overhook, if he has the underhook. Okay, I can do this too. Generally, I'm gonna come over, I'm gonna grab the gi. Okay, I'm gonna grab the gi. I'm gonna grab this lapel, this far side lapel to give me a better control. So if he has the underhook, I get the far side control. Now I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna control this arm, and I'm gonna sweep. Now look, this is the same detail here, guys. Look, I don't want like kick away, all right? Look, see, I don't get, I put this right down next to his hip, blocking. Okay, now the most he can do is try to move his foot. We already know how to clear that. Alright? I keep that pressure on his hip the whole time. So the only thing different here is that I can do this with the overhook as well. Okay? And then I suck up this leg. Boom. Look, I cut the knee. This foot stays posted here. I cut the knee. Okay? I'm not trying to kick it out of the way and give him space to get the knee back in or come up to his knees, okay? Pressure with my foot. Boom. Right? Just pressure my foot till the knee comes across. Now if he tries to come up, I'm in a good position here. This is a little bit tricky disengaging from. It's a little advanced here, right? I'm not gonna come to the scar. What am I gonna do? Come to side control. We're disengaging that arm. Check. So I can do it with the underhook, which sets me up for a good underhook when I come up. Or I can do it off the overhook, but I just gotta be, it's a little trickier when we get to the top. Check.
What has all the way over there? Want me to make me yell and laugh?
Get in the sweet zone. You can be in the beauty camp. That looks good. It's like, if you're not in the beauty camp, it looks like I'm just teaching nobody.
Alright? Alright, so we're here again. Look, guys, if he's got an underhook on me here, he's feeling pretty good.
once I start doing this, what's he gonna do? Start basing back. When he bases back, see where we're at? Now what do I have right here?
Sit up,
here. I get my belt grip because I like it. Okay, he's feeling good, like he's got a head position and all this kind of stuff. Now, as I start to put the pressure to sweep him this way, he stands up on his foot to block it. Okay? So one of the first things that I can do is a quick switch. Even with this here, right? I'm blocking this arm. He has his underhook. All I'm going to do is switch my hips and my hook. And he goes over quite easily. Okay? So this is just the switch. I switch from my right elevator hook or butterfly hook to my left. Okay? And because he stepped up and committed to blocking me here, it's right? As soon as my hips switch, that foot's going up. And he's already put his hips on that angle. Right? So we're here, he's got that underhook, he's feeling aggressive. I start to sweep, he stands up with this foot, right? So now, instead of, okay, I'm not going to be able to sweep him this way, but I'm just going to really quick watch. As soon as my hip hits, my foot's already up. And he's off balance. I'm letting go right now because I don't want him coming down on my grip and crushing my fingers. But you can hold on to that and stay very tight. Just open your hand so that you don't get your fingers smashed with it. Holding on to the belt. Check. Okay, so over here, boom, he's fighting for the underhook, right? He gets the underhook, now he's feeling more confident. I start to sweep, he stands up. Okay, so very quickly, I switch my hips. Now look, I'm blocking his arm. If he's trying to base, he doesn't get much of a base. And there's an additional arm lock there as well. Okay, so we're down. Fight, he gets that underhook. Now he's more aggressive. He's even got it, but he feels to be a good head position. Right? So I start the sweep, pop, posture's up. Right? Now he's got some good pressure. I block this, I switch right away. I don't know that that's very high. He's going to scramble and stuff. So I would stay on top and finish that out. The sweep come up on top. Check. Any questions? I see people show that move though as like legit, so just be careful, don't hurt them. Good? Let's do the switch butterfly sweep. Get this underhook, he gets the underhook, he's feeling good, gets a good head position, he's feeling all like, oh, I'm good to go. So sometimes, I'll start the sweep and he steps up or he doesn't step up, but he's really controlling this leg. Really, really trying to control this leg here. So he's trying to pin it down so he can go around to my right, his left, right? He's trying to circle, right? This type of thing, right? He's pushing his knee in on the foot and he's trying to circle out the other way to come around the other side. So now, I'm gonna just scooch back this way a little bit so you guys can see, right? As he starts to change that angle and tries to come around, I have the diagonal sweep. Okay, I'm going to use the same hook that I was going to sweep. I'm going to use my right hook on his left leg, but now I'm going to go right foot to right foot and hit the diagonal sweep. Okay, it's diagonal because my hook goes from this side to that side. Diagonal, right? Okay, so again, this works off this overhook, right? He can have his underhook. Can I do it with the underhook? You bet. I'm just not killing this arm as effectively. All right, so he's really blocking this leg. He's trying to use his knee to block here, trying to make an angle to go over the other side. Okay, so I make sure I got a clean shot at that leg. I take this hook across, and I bring him over, okay? I like to pick up this leg, stay tight with his shoulder pressure, opening my hand on his back so I don't get my fingers all mashed up on his body weight. So I open it and I have like kind of 100 kilos on his chin. Check. So again, I'm always gonna look for that underhook, but if he battles quick and gets it, I don't sweat it. Okay? I start playing my game, he starts playing his game, he's close on his leg, trying to go around the corner. Look, that hook's already there. Okay, he wants to go that way. taken that way. Check. Any questions on the diagonal sweep? Okay. It's not that much look on the scissor diagonal sweep, right? But here, generally, we've got this cross grip, right? And then we sweep them over this way, same type of thing, okay? So I can do this off of that same type of, if I've got like a two-on-one type grip here, right? Failed arm drag, we're fighting over this arm drag, right? He's not gonna, yeah, see, look. I can still do this off of anything when I'm killing that arm. He's trying to circle to the right, or his left, either way. Check? Questions? Let's do it, diagonal sweep. Setting up for the butterfly sweep here, but then I switch, and sweep with this leg, okay. And it's what? Switch.
Okay.
Who's bearing grass to me? Right? You know what I'm talking about? All right. It's not a trick question. So now if I use this other leg, now it's a diagonal. Check? So I either hit the switch or I hit the diagonal. But sometimes when he's changing that angle on me, that I can't hit the switch because his leg's too far back. So I got to get this leg to reach him and catch him. Check? Now, you got that underhook, he's feeling good. I go for it anyways. Okay, but he bases up and he's kind of hanging back here, right? I'm on my side. I can't get the leverage down. Okay, so now we're gonna do the reverse butterfly sweep. Okay, from here I'm gonna dive my arm under the leg. Okay, and I'm gonna scoop my hips. I'm gonna scoop my hips underneath them. Again, I'm looking to kill this arm by bringing this elbow down. When I scoop my hips underneath him, I can take him to my right. Look, my hook stays in place here. He's very light.
thing as well. So I'm flat, I don't have anywhere to go, but I have a lot of leverage here. Yeah, so see what you just did? When you bring that leg up, you stop it. So I reach under, I scoot under. Feel the difference?
Here we go. So that's the reverse butterfly. Okay? So we got the regular, the switch, the diagonal, and the reverse. Let's do the reverse. So now, arm drag. If I'm back here and he starts controlling my pants, I need to deal with this, okay? I'm gonna do three things at once. I'm gonna pull my foot towards me. I'm gonna grab his sleeve or his wrist, okay? And I'm gonna grab across here, okay? I'm gonna need to do, so, one, two, three, okay? Boom. Boom. Okay, drill it. Okay, now once I get to here, I'm gonna kick and pull his arm across. Kick, pull his arm across, and then kind of hip high slide.
Into here. I come to my elbow, my chest is on his back here. My arm is across. Where am I going? Back. To his back. I'm on my elbow, so where do I go to next?
Knee.
My knee with the hook in, okay? My hook's inside. Not my,
what? Grapevine. I don't have the grapevine in this, will slow me down. Just the hook.
And then I come over to the back to get the far side hook. Okay?
So from the other side here, three things at once. Foot comes up, okay? Control the wrist, control the triceps above the elbow. Deeper the better, right? Practice it. Now, I kick my leg off. One, pull his arm across. Two, right? And slide in, pull into my elbow here. If I do those out of order, I jam myself up with his arm, okay? I need to get his arm across before I slide in. People do this. They go boom, and then they try to slide in as they're pulling the arm across, and they jam themselves up. And now I put myself in the half guard with him having the underhook. Okay? So get to here, boom, pull the arm across, now slide in. It's an important timing thing. Okay? I'm on my elbow, I'm reaching over here, I'm staying tight, my chest is on his shoulder. So if he's trying to escape, if he's trying to come up, I've got good pressure here. Right? Elbow, knee, hand, come up and take the back. Mike, please. Okay. So, one, two, three, all at the same time. Right? Boom. Then I kick it off, pull the arm across. Boom. Now I sit as I'm dragging.
To my elbow. I can grab this far side, pull on the knee, far hook. I'm up on the back attack.
Once more from the other side. One, two, three. Okay. So arm drag from the butterfly. Just like any other arm drag, I gotta change his angle before I come in. So focus on getting that arm past you before you try to come in. Okay? Same side as he's grabbing, wrist control, opposite side, triceps. Boom, boom. Good to go. Okay, either way, so I can choose to come here if I want to sit to guard and already have this control, or I can bail out of a takedown if he's trying to get the takedown and get to a controlling position. Okay? So what I'm gonna do is pull on the lapel. What's he gonna do usually? Pull back, right? So at the same time as I'm pulling with the lapel, I'm reaching and grabbing this knee here. If I can't get a hold of the material, I reach and I block the knee either way. Okay? So as I pull, I grab.
mean? Okay? As he sits back, I'm gonna sit, bring my foot back and sit up over my knee, driving him over here on the 45, back over this way. Okay? I'm controlling the knee and I'm driving. Now, I don't want him to take my back. I put my elbow across the center line and put pressure here. I pick the sleeve back up, right? If he's trying to take my back, the harder he takes my back, the more pressure he gets from my elbow here. Okay? I'm gonna sit through. A lot of pressure there, right? And then because if he's reaching up high with his arm, I can pummel and get the underhook. Or what I like to do is come after I sit through, step over and wrap the arm back around here and be in a position to attack. Okay, over here, I've got my grip. As I pull, I reach for the knee. As he sits up, I sit up over my knee, riding him back over this way. Okay, boom, I cut the knee. I'm in what kind of position here? Like I just did what pass? Cross knee pass, except I don't have that underhook. So I put my elbow where that elbow would be in the underhook, pontoon out. As he's trying to escape, I'm picking up this sleeve, right? I sit through. Come up on the top. Okay? It's not uncommon, like I said, if I can't pick up, if the pants are too tight, okay, when he sits back, I block the knee, okay? As I sit up over the leg, he may put his hand on the ground here. That's perfectly fine because look, I want the sleeve anyways. So I reach out and I grab it. Okay? Pull and grab or block. As he comes back, I sit up, I drive him over. If he stops with a hand, that's fine. Pick it up, drive him across. Elbows across the center line. As he's trying to come up and take my back, I sit through. Okay, so we're working from our grips from earlier. I'm gonna pull and grab. As he pulls back, I sit up over the knee, driving him over to the side. Okay, like I'm doing a cross knee. My elbow's across. I don't have the underhook, so I put it there. Even if he pushes on my elbow, tries to take my back, this is a lot of weight and a lot of pressure. Okay, and then I step forward. Bases with the arm, which is very common. Okay, I pull, as he sits back up, I go, nope, come back up. Blocks with this arm, kick it up, boom. Okay, still in the same position here, sit through. Okie dokie, any questions? Let's pair it up. Okay, so now guys, where there's a push, there's a pull, and where there's a pull, there's a push, okay? If I'm pushing into him, and he's pushing back into me, okay? And this can be off, this is a great sequence, okay? I pull, I grab, he sits back, and I'm too slow, and he's pushing back into me here, okay? When he pushes back into me, I want my fist in this shoulder. When he pushes back into me, I put my my elbow to his shoulder, okay? Pushing back in, elbow to shoulder. Now I reach over the back of the head and I pummel this in the crook of my elbow. I keep my elbow down and I pull up with my arm. And the most important part here, guys, is look, I change the shape of my wrist. See, the whole idea is to make this space as small as possible. When I do this at the same time, see how that makes that a lot smaller? So I go shoulder, elbow to shoulder, so this is under his chin. I come over the top, right? Look, I trap his head with my body. My arm, it's kind of like I'm waving over here with my fingers. I put this elbow down, and I'm pulling up, but look, I still don't have it.
Watch, as soon as I put that, as soon as I put that wrist up, it's on. Does that make sense? Okay, so I push, he pushes back into me. Elbow goes to the shoulder, hand comes over and through, waving. Okay, I'm pulling up on my elbow, pushing down with this elbow. Okay, now I pull on the gi, but I also put my wrist up and get the tap. Okay? Yep. Why don't you let me show, use Andrew as a demonstrator. Let's do it from this side once. Okay? So I've got my grip, I'm pushing. As he pushes back, my elbow goes to his shoulder. My hand comes over, I get on top of his head. Okay? I'm here, hands wide. I'm pushing this elbow down, this elbow up. But the big key is that wrist. Okay, that wrist going up. Feel that? Okay, now the nice thing about this guy is once I get to here, if he is defending the choke by bringing his hands up, right, then he's not in a position to defend the sweep. And I can turn it into a sweep. And I've already got a grip, but I'm right on the attack here. Okay, there's a bunch of different attacks. Pretty cool, huh? Okay? So, pull, go from here, sit back, if I sit up, push him back into me, boom, right into here. If he starts to fend him, brings his hands up, I sweep, and look, I'm on top with a good grip, and I can start attacking. There you go. Let's do it. It's that same elevator butterfly sweep that we worked on yesterday. So if I find out now we're down on the knees, we kind of worked our way down. If I get to a point, we're going to kind of work from tight to further out. If I get to a point where I have double unders, okay, I've got a couple choices here. Okay, what I like to do is start pushing out his legs here a little bit, okay, and then threaten to sit up over the knee. Okay, if I do this right, if my timing is good, I can actually take him back over the side. If I take him straight back, what happens to him? Yeah, his ankles are owie. So be nice. If you do sit up on the knee, take him to the side so that he can go over the foot instead of going straight back over these feet back here. Okay? But generally, he's going to feel that. Okay, so he's going to feel that, he's going to try to set up over and he's going to push back into me. So what I can do is I'm going to keep this tight, all right, I'm going to stay really tight to him here, okay, and I start working my way around. Right now, he's worried about his base. I can try to sweep here, but if he bases, that's fine. Look, I stay tight and I work my way around to the back. Okay, I can kind of dug, shrug, whatever. But the more I put him off base, he's got to get this arm to keep his balance. Does that make sense? So if I get a good body lock, keep a tight body lock, work around to the side, and come out to the back. Okay, it's not off the duck under. Remember, we can do it off the duck under too, if he's pummeling. As soon as he starts to pummel, all right? No, pummel for the under. When he brings his arm off to pummel, we can thread the duck under. Okay, but if he doesn't, then I start upsetting his base, working the sweep. Now he's got a base, don't let me sweep you. Don't let me sweep you.
Right? See, I'm pushing with my feet, but I'm staying tight to the body here.
Check. Push with the feet and make the space, but stay body locked. Keep that bear hug around him. Let's do it once more from this side. Am I okay on your ribs?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're here, I'm body locked, staying tight. I'm gonna threaten the sweep, okay, here, but he's basic. So I push with the leg, right? Come up, I'm staying tight, and I come around to the back. Okie dokie, let's do it. Moving my game forward, that's fine. If he gets his grips, you know, we talked about this yesterday, I can work my arm drag, go to the back. So we've got stuff out here. I also showed you you, you know, if I get in a position with this good underhook that I've got a good attack here. But sometimes I'm sitting here trying to fight for grips, trying to get my underhooks, and he's not having it, he's pummeling back or whatever, or he'll just try to keep some space here, okay? But if I can get at least my hands under his armpits, okay? Both my hands under his armpits, all I need to do is scoop my hips, scoop my butt in, and lift him up from my legs, okay? I want to take my hands in his armpits and raise him up like this. This gives me space now. Duck, okay? I duck under, and I push him off to the side. Okay. Pummel under, right? I scoop my hips in, bring him up. Look, I duck my head under, and I push him over the side. Generally, he's gonna try to keep his base, okay? So, I come to here, and I take his back. Okay? Elbow, knee, power hook. Okay? So pummeling in here. If I can get both hands under, he may be cross-faced, he may be pushing away, whatever it is. Okay? I scoop my butt in, lift him up with my legs, hands here. Okay? Now, duck under. Push him away. You are a horrible bookie.
Used to be good here.
Okay, so just come down to your knees, okay? Because generally guys aren't gonna stay all. If they are, there's other things to do, okay? So I'm here. Come on. I duck. I'm pushing him over. Okay, look. Get this across just like we normally do. Shoulder up on his. Chest up on his shoulder, I'm on my elbow, okay? Knee, and I get my far side hook in. I've already got my grips, and I'm attacking. Okay?
Head, please.
So if I can get both hands under, okay? I scoop my hips in, bring him up. See my hand position? Okay, I duck under here. I push him off to the side and back. Okay, my chest is on his shoulder. I'm already up on my elbow. Even if he's trying to pummel back on me, I come up to my knee. I should be feeding this lapel as I get my far side hook. Good to go. Good. Okay. So we're gonna build on to the rock up that we did. Okay, we had that rock up. The first rock up we did was coming out to take the back. Okay, coming up, you know, using that to duck under to take the back. He may do something differently when I try to rock up. Okay, if I rock up, boom, he may get his legs down and stand. Okay, when I go to rock up, I'm trying to bring him over me, but he gets his feet down. Okay, when he does this, right away I have to recognize those hands are on the ground, or those feet are on the ground. I'm gonna grab those feet and go knees up, sitting up over the knee with a double ankle pull off the rock. Okay? So again, pommel, I can't get all the way in there, I'm not close enough to get my duck under. I hit the rock up, okay, but he goes hips in, gets his feet down. Right, if I really try to rock him up here, his feet are gonna be right near my hips. I reach and grab. Look, my hips go up, right? Hips go up and sweep them back, sitting up over the knee. Okay? And then I'm in a, you know, open guard combat knee, or I can stand and go to my offensive passing posture. Any questions? No? Okay, stop. Okay, so our last one for today here is when I do the rock up. Get this rock up. This is a really strong situation here. Okay? I can just duck under, or I can bring it all the way around. If he's basing here, this makes my life even easier. I'm gonna bring my arm across. Okay, arm across, my knee across. See where my knee is here? My knee's up in the hip. Okay, so my shin is blocking his hips. Okay, then my leg comes over.
and I've got the knee bar. Okay?
Pummeling in, right? I get two overhooks, but not deep enough. I swing my hips in for the rock up,
right? He's here. Look, I pass this under and here, right? I come under the arm, under the leg. This knee comes across to the hip here, and this leg comes over the top. I hug. Now, if I need to change my angle, I change my angle, and I stay on the knee bar. Okay? Once more. Okay. Rock up, boom, all the way through, spinning to the knee bar. Okay? Real critical to pay attention to this arm placement and the knee placement, right? When I get to here, my hands switch, right? I'm coming under the leg with this one and under the arm with this one. Knee comes across the hips. So it's kind of like a little cross knee thing here, right? Isolate the knee right into it. If he's changed his angle, right? Then I want to try to bring this out, flatten him out, get back into the knee bar.
Yep. So we're working the butterfly guard. I want to work from standing and down. We've been working side to side, left and right, with all of our elevators and basic butterfly sweep and reverse and inverted and peg leg. That's all left and right. So now we're working more forward and back. All right, so we start with him standing. All right, well, usually if he's standing, he's looking to control my knees or something along those lines. I always look, this is my number one. I think this is in the basic curriculum, but it's so money, it'd be horrible for me not to go over it. Okay, I get a cross grip on the collar, hand comes out, I shrink my butt out this way, and I get dragged to the back. Okay, it's simple, but hugely effective. Okay? If I get my grip, Mike's gonna stabilize and not let me sweep him. Don't let me sweep you. Okay? Stabilize, don't let it happen. Good? Okay? It's just leverage. He's only got 2 points of contact. I'm changing the angle and I get the drag and I look to the back. Okay? Remember, I'm going to put this, I can go foot inside too, but now my feet are inside, I got to contend with this. Not the end of the world. Okay, pull that up, put the hook. Remember guys, you want to get tight to that shoulder so his arm is not trapped. I'm trying to get that arm out, he's helping me. Come up, elbow, knee, far side hook. Okay? If I do this, and he's up right away, he catches himself and stands right up right away. We're coming up looking for the single, okay? Because it's right there. He's standing up, he's trying to get his balance. Now let's sit right up and take the single. Cool? Any questions? All right, collar grab. Go. All right, so this next one is straight out of the Jacare book. He's squaring up, we're trying to fight for our grips, whatever it is. Generally, he steps in, all right? He's coming in, he's trying to set up to where he can get his grips and things like that. Guys, anytime I can put both feet behind, I hook last. I start reaching and I hook last. I push his hips, right? It works, and I think I've done it to you before, so don't sit there and laugh. This is one of those stupid things. If you get me with this at the gym, you can do this one to me, okay? That's fine. Just not the collar grab and not the puppet. All right, so as soon as he gets enough range here, we're hand fighting. As soon as I can cover that, I'm going to push it on his hips, pick up that foot, sit up over the knee. Okay, right away, pick up that foot so that he's, otherwise we're racing to sit up and then we'll clunk heads, right? But pick up that foot. You gotta look for him. We're moving around, he's trying to get in and get his grips. Look, I can even be out, he can be here, right? Look, I scoop my butt in. Okay? And don't make a noise, it's rude. Okay? We're moving around. He can be staying out. Let's stay outside a little bit. Right? Moving around. Right? I pull myself in. Now I'm in range. Pick up that foot. Okay? You don't have to leg drag. I just like it. I think it's a good transition. Because it right away puts me into a passing scenario. Any questions? You guys, I just call this the double, triple hip push. I don't really have any. Okay, straight out of competition videos though. Works on black belts. Let's do it.
If he's moving back, if I try to do this one and he's moving back or we're just moving, or if I have the space here where I can come up over, I can get the ankle pick, just the one hand, all right? And I'm gonna drive the opposite hip, okay? So I can ankle pick, I'm not gonna cross pick because then I don't have the, it's just a regular ankle pick here, all right? So we're working, I can come up and I pick up this ankle and I push. Guys, this is also very effective when he starts to transition down, or say he's on both knees, right? And he steps up, and this foot is here, okay? Or even outside, it's fine. If this is near vertical, then most of his weight's back there, so it's pretty easy to hit a pick here. Does that make sense? So hit that ankle. If he's standing, it helps to have a little bit of a push in the hip. And again, we keep going to our left and right series from that. Any questions? Single pick with the hip push. Let's do it. Alright, so we're working this butterfly guard, right? I try to pommel, but he's been training more than a couple weeks, so he knows to pommel and get the underhook. Alright, so he gets the underhook, he's fairly insistent on. I can use this to my advantage. I'm gonna overhook and grab this collar. Okay? From here, alright, I can still attempt to sweep. Right? If he bases out wide, that gives me space. I'll be nice about this. That gives me space to bring my feet up in the hips, control, and hit my armpit armbar here. Okay? If he fights his way back in with this underhook, right? Pull your arm out. He's trying to get his arm out, you hit what? Right? We get the Americana, right? If he turns it the other way, right, we transition to the Omaha block. Okay, this should be a fairly familiar series, just that it's off the overhook now instead of the underhook. Okay? So I can play the same game. I just have to change my control point on the arm lock a little bit. So again, I'm trying to get this underhook, establish dominance. Pommels, he's very insistent on it. I reach under, I grab the gi, I continue to work the sweep. He bases out. As he bases out, this gives me plenty of room to bring my feet up, control the hips. I come to my side, yeah, I got, the more I pinch my knees together, the tighter it gets, all right? I need to kind of sit back to bring my arm and shoulder across his elbow. If I stay in tight here, then his arm stays bent, okay? If his arm stays bent, but he's trying to get it out of there, right? Then we transition to that Americana, right? Again, it fights back in, pushing back into it, right? We can transition to the omoplata fairly easily. There's plenty of space there. Check. All right, any questions? All right, bring it in here, guys. So, go ahead, stop. If I do work this, if I do get the underhook and I start to sweep and he bases out with his arms, right, where are we? Cutting arm lock, right? But what will happen a lot of times is when I start to do this, he's going to try to fight his way back in towards me. When he does this, he becomes very sweepable to the other side, Okay, the more online he gets trying to fight this, you can take him either way. Generally, I take him to the trapped arm side because of the leverage I get from my elbow. Okay, get the other hook, I start to sweep, he bases out with all his hands and arms, right? I come to here because it's above, right? I start working this cutting arm bar. He's fighting his way back in, all right? Look, see this little lever here? I keep this here. All right, he's pushing in, he's trying to bring this arm together. I keep him stretched out on a line. Look, I have an extra lever here on his face. Take him over. A lot of times I'll just stay right on this and finish it from the top. Check. There's another variation of this that Jason really likes from sitting up, right? He'll kind of work this to begin with, to isolate the arm and start working it, and then when he fights back in, hit the sweep. So you can fight for it from sitting up, or you can get it and when he pushes back in, you take him the other way.
Questions on the cutting? Okay, stop.
Right, so now, we're here, we're pummeling, right? You got down the hook, you down the hook, you pummel, boom, right? Oh my goodness gracious. Right? Am I going to finish this choke from here? Probably not. But as he tries to get his arm out of here, he becomes very easy to sweep. Now look guys, I'll leave my knee right up in the chest.
And finish the choke from there. Okay? You don't have the leverage generally from the butterfly, but you're ducking under off the pump. Right? But a lot of times, I'll have the underhook here, and he'll be trying to pummel. So I beat him. Okay? Not off the pummel, but it's over under. I feel him start to bring that arm off the pummel. Look, I duck under. This arm's still on top. I can get over this very quickly. Now, I'm not using a lot of strength. He's spread out here. My feet are here breaking down his base. The more I break down the base, the easier he is to sweep. Right? I get this arm nice and tight. Go head to head, right? And yeah.
Put the head and arm triangle.
So we've got the head and arm grip for the sweep, and then you finish with the head and arm triangle.
Good to go.
Questions on that one? Okay, we'll come back through and practice each one, okay? All right, guys. So now, a lot of times if he's trying to drive us down with his head, if he puts his head down lower, it's really easy to go to the guillotine, okay? Or I can snap him down, right? Here, I'm not getting close enough for this, right? But look, I snap him down into the guillotine. When I start working the guillotine, he's gonna generally bring his hands in to defend, okay? Once he brings his hands in to defend,
I sweep, I go to the mount, and I can finish both hands or one hand.
Right, that mounted guillotine. It's one of the great things about this butterfly sweep is it's so, you can hit it off of so many things. As soon as his base is compromised, you've got your body momentum and his, and as soon as you've got him broke down to just 2 points, once you get him on 1 point, it's over. Okay, so we're here, he's keeping his head a little bit low. I snap it down, I start working this guillotine. Right, if I get a good squeeze, he's gonna bring those hands in. Now look, I go to the side, I get the sweep, I stay high on the mount so that I can finish this. And sometimes you can finish it with both hands, but if you need to base to keep him from rolling back through, get flat to his hand to finish it on the single, right? We've done the single hand and mounted guillotine before. Check. Any questions? If he's trying to control my legs, he's susceptible to leg drag, okay? The arm drag. Our basic arm drag, we teach trying to bring this leg out so that we've got a straight line to the back, okay? Sometimes it doesn't work that well, and our feet are stuck. We get the arm, right? We get the arm, boom, but my feet are stuck. Okay, look, I'm gonna stay tight to here, I'm gonna grab on, right? If he's trying to get his arm out, it's very difficult.
right? And if he pushes into me at all, then again, I have the sweep for the mount. Stay on the arm so that it's isolated. Check. Don't let him pull that arm back. Stay on this side of the elbow with your body. Check. Alright, so my feet are jammed up, I can't get them out, okay? But I get a good arm grab. I grab onto the gi, I get tight, right? Generally, he's trying to see how I scoop my butt in, not pull him back, bring him over. Look, stay on the side of the arm. He's gonna be trying to get his arm back. I stay on it. Good to go? Any questions?